In this video, I am going to explain biomechanical relationship on lower limb. Particularly, I want to focus on how ankle restriction can affect knee, hip, and even for pelvis. Okay? When ankle does plantar flexion or dorsiflexion, you notice not only ankle joint is moving, also hip is moving. You see that? How about this way? Now, knee is moving as well. So, when one joint moves, other joint should be moving freely. But when there's restriction somewhere, the flow of movement is aggravated somewhere. Let's say if I on purposely creates restriction here, his knee doesn't move as much as before because flow of this energy is aggravated here. No restriction, knee moves. Plus there is tibia and fibula. If somebody's tibia and fibula doesn't move, now knee joint cannot move. Let's say if I create restriction here, see, his leg doesn't move as much as before. Plantar flexion, see, that moves. Dorsiflexion, it moves. Okay, do you see this relationship? There's a chain connection. Ankle joint, tibia fibula, knee joint, knee is organized by tibia and femur. If knee doesn't move, his hip does not move. Why? Because hip joint is composed by pelvis and femur. If this part doesn't move, his femur doesn't move. Thus, his hip doesn't move. This cause can be from ankle joint. If this place is really, really, really tight, his knee cannot move, his knee doesn't move, femur doesn't move. If femur doesn't move, hip does not move. Let's see. His tibialis anterior is tight. Let's see how this tightness affects rest of the leg. Okay, this is before treatment. I do myofascial release very quickly. This is not full treatment, but let's see. Let's just see how one part of tightness affects whole leg. Of course, there are many ways to analyze biomechanical connection. You can say tibia and fibula are internally rotated, and femur are externally rotated, yadda yadda yadda. I don't want to go too much detail about this thing. There are so many methods about biomechanical connection, but I want to give you the basic principle that everything is connected, everything is related. Good. Let's see how this quick treatment affects leg. Plantar flexion. There's flow of energy through leg. See that? When I dorsiflexion, his knee moves and his femur moves and hip moves. Do you see there's nice flow throughout leg? Some places can be tight, but at least you see change, right? So one spot, one tightness can affect rest of body. So looking body is looking body as one unit is important to analyze each joint. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment and subscribe. See you next video.